Ladies and gentlemen, good day and welcome to the conference call for analysts and investors to discuss the financial results and performance for the quarter ended 30th June 2021 of the Anup Engineering Limited. As a reminder, all participant lines will be in the listen-only mode, and there will be an opportunity for you to ask questions after the presentation concludes. Should you need assistance during the conference call, please signal an operator by pressing star then zero on your touchtone phone. Please note that this conference is being recorded. I now hand the conference over to Mr. Bhavesh Shah. Thank you, and over to you, sir.
Yeah, thank you. Good afternoon, everybody. Thanks for participating in the call. Hope you have all gone through the press release and the investor presentation for Q1 posted in the exchange. I'm joined with our Chief Executive Officer, Mr. Rishi Kapoor, and Company Secretary, Mr. Chintan Patel from our site. As you would be aware, Anup Engineering is a large group company having global presence in heavy engineering business since 1962. We cater to a wide range of process equipment in oil and gas, petrochemical, LNG, fertilizers, and pharmaceuticals with extensive product range of heat exchanger, reactors, pressure vessels, columns, and tower, and industrial centrifuge and forms components. Now I'll run through the financials for the current quarter. Despite the second year of COVID.
Sir, we are not able to hear you clearly.
Yeah, I'll just keep it near to me. Now it's better?
Much better, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Yeah, so now I'll run through the financials for the current quarter. Despite the second wave of COVID, we had our best Q1 ever in the current quarter. The revenue from the operations was 52 crores. Against 30 crores in last year Q1 FY21, up by 22%. The EBITDA margin is at 24%. PAT is at 8.1 crores against 5.2 crores in last year Q1 FY21, up by 55%. We are having a very strong order book position as on 30th June was nearing 300 crores. And happy to tell that since beginning of Q1 till date, we have booked orders of 51 crores till date, which gives us very good visibility for the coming quarter. Since 1st of July, yeah. Our liquidity position is very strong. We have a fixed deposit balance of 52 crores, 52.5 crores as on June end. Other information is available in the presentation, and now we will start with the question answer session. Thank you.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, we will now begin with the question and answer session. Anyone wishing to ask a question may please press star and one on your touchtone telephone. If you wish to remove yourself from the question queue, you may press star and two. Participants are requested to use handsets while asking a question. Ladies and gentlemen, we will wait for a moment while the question queue assembles. The first question is from the line of Kaushal Shah from Dhanki Securities. Please go ahead.
Thank you very much, sir, for the opportunity and congratulations for the great set of numbers. Sir, I had a few questions. One was if you can share some updates regarding the Odhav plant. I believe the clean room there was delayed due to the COVID second wave. Also an update on the KEDA construction. And if you can, kind of share some more color on the order inflows that we've had, meaning which are the, key sectors, so as to say. And do we, stick to this, if I'm not mistaken, in the Q4 call, we were expecting inflows of around 300 or 330 crores for the current year, 21-22. So do we maintain that same inflow target, or we want to revise it upwards?
So good afternoon to you, Kaushal. This is Rishi here. And first of all, to begin with, you know, let me begin with by answering your the last question that you had. That's regarding the order book. So we indeed had a good run in booking the orders since the 1st of April, since the year opened. We have gone ahead and booked almost about 150 crore already. It's there on the, it's already booked. So which is, you can say, one of the best run rates that we've had in terms of order booking. And we are pretty much on track with the initial, indications that we had given, the expectations about booking orders to the tune of about 330, 350 crores in the current year. So that's very much on, because we've had a very good start. And the order, the inquiry pipeline is continuing to be very robust and very strong, both from the international as well as domestic markets. So that's one part of the question. Of course, the second is an update on on the CapEx progress in Udhav. So the clean room project, yes, it did take a hit in the second wave of COVID. We really had to, it was pulled back by almost 2 months. But since I think beginning of June, we have been able to gather momentum in the progress that we are going to make, that we are making in this project. And we are certain that we will be able to complete the project in the month of September, anywhere between 15th to 30th of September. The whole bay, including the clean room, is targeted to be commissioned.
Right. Regarding the Kheda plant, sir, we were expecting regulatory approvals and...
The Kheda plant also, the regulatory approvals are very much in place, and the work should... We are currently in the process of renewing the contracts, renegotiating the contracts, which we had already placed, in the last year before the COVID struck. So those contracts are going to be renewed. We are going to renegotiate those contracts. That's the process which has already started. We intend to begin the first phase of construction in this quarter, in the current Q2.
Right. And so, this significant order inflow momentum that we've seen, if you can, throw a little more color on which are the sectors that we are seeing, a lot of traction or activity. And how do you see the forthcoming, let's say, the next 4 or maybe 6 quarters ahead?
So, we had mentioned in the past also that primarily, the order book continues to be from our conventional sectors, which is, refining downstream, oil and gas. But to the extent of about 68%. However, some very good progress we have been able to make, significant progress in other sectors. For example, chemicals. We have been able to make good progress in power sector.
Yeah.
And we have been able to.
Hello.
Yes. So the chemical sector contributes about 12%. The power sector is about 2%, though it's really a very high proportion as of now, but it's a good, it's a new business stream. It's a new revenue stream that has been opened up. We made some good breakthroughs with some of the global leaders in the sector. And of course, fertilizer will continue to, provide us with more opportunities. So happy to state there that slowly, we are making progress in other sectors other than the conventional, refining sector. So almost about 32% is coming now from non-refining sectors. So that's a great sign for us.
Sure, that's great to hear.
And the momentum of the inquiries is I do not see any letup in that. In fact, we are getting better choices. Because as we are going forward, we are improving our product mix, we are getting approvals, we are getting, our track record is becoming better than before, and it is opening up doors for us on new product mix, new product categories, new customers, So it's pretty, you know, kind of the expected market for us is going to be quite positive in the future.
Yeah, that's great to hear, sir. Just one final question from my side before I come back in the queue. On the gross margin side, you know, I think you had said in the past that we will maintain this 47% kind of range. So, you know, given the RM, you know, price pressure that is coming across the board virtually for all companies, do we expect to kind of maintain this range, you know, given that, you know, you're saying that the inquiries continue to be very strong, the order bookings are very strong. So are we able to kind of get orders at decent margins, or we've had to, you know, do a little bit of compromise there?
No, I think we have already mentioned, I think at the end, you know, when we announced the last financial year results, I think we pretty much maintain the same margins. You know, there could be a hit of a couple of percentage points, you know, instead of 25-26% that we have been consistently showing on EBITDA, maybe it could come down to about 23-24%. But that's about it. And we are confident of sustaining this.
Great, great. Sir, I'll come back in with you. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, in order to ensure that the management is able to address questions from all participants in this conference, we request you to limit your questions to two per participant only. If time permits, you can come back in the question queue for a follow-up question. The next question is on the line of Tapan Karnik from Habrock Capital. Please go ahead. Mr. Karnik, your line is in the talk mode. Please go ahead. Mr. Karnik, your line is in the talk mode. Please go ahead. As there's no response from the current participant, we'll move on to the next. That is from the line of Ravi Naredi from Naredi Investments. Please go ahead. Mr. Naredi, your line is in the talk mode. Please go ahead. Mr. Ravi Naredi? As there's no response from the current participant, we'll move on to the next. That is on the line of Hardik Jain from Whitestone Advisors Private Limited. Please go ahead.
Yeah, hi sir, thank you for the opportunity. Sir, just wanted to understand with the kind of good order book, order intake that we are getting, I just wanted to understand, so the heat exchanger and the vessel, the major products that we make, does it generally go into a new greenfield or brownfield expansion, or does it also go to an existing plant where they want to enhance their efficiency and, you know, capture the heat that they are losing? So does it go even in the existing plants, or it generally goes to the new capex?
No, most definitely it also is required, you know, in an existing plant as well, because the equipment which are already installed there, they are like, you know, they would need periodic replacements.
Okay.
So definitely, you know, a shutdown and replacement is a major business segment for us.
Okay, so just please excuse my ignorance, because I'm new to this company. So heat exchanger is basically a product which helps a company to, you know, capture the heat and use it to generate some kind of energy, is it?
So it is one of the, you know, wide range of process equipment. You can say that it's one of the most widely used process equipment in the whole range. If you would see our you know, presentation as well, you will find other product categories, other process equipment categories like vessels and tower and reactors. And yes, primarily the function of a heat exchanger is to transfer the heat from one medium to another. That's the primary function, and it is used in widely wide-ranging applications in any process plant. So it finds application across industry sectors.
Yeah, so our target customers would not just be the ones who are looking for a new expansion or new capex, but will also be hitting plants where they need to enhance their efficiencies.
Most definitely.
Yeah, okay. That's it. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Chetan Vora from Abacus. Please go ahead.
Yeah, hi, good evening. Good evening, sir. Sir, I wanted to ask, you know, okay, well, how's the demand environment looking like?
Can you see, Chetan, could you be a little louder?
Yeah, is it clear now? Hello?
Yes. Please
yeah,
go
yeah.
ahead.
Yeah, so I was asking, you know, how the demand environment looks like, sir?
How the Q1?
Pardon, Chetan, can you be more louder?
I was asking, you know, how the demand environment is looking like, you know, post, you know, this COVID-2 getting waned away.
Yeah, Chetan, maybe you joined a little late, but, you know, we just discussed about it, that the market, you know, the demand continues to be quite strong. And we have had one of the best runs in the last, you know, maybe 45 days, 50 days since the time, you know, in this new financial year. And we have booked close to the extent of about 150 crore.
Yeah.
Of orders have already been booked, so we see the trend continuing in the coming you know quarters.
And these 150 crores will be including the 50 crores order what you got post June also, right?
Yes.
Okay. And in terms of yeah, and in terms of margins, did I heard it correctly that you said that for the full year it could be in the range of 24%? Is it right?
Yes. The EBITDA would be in the region of about 24% is what we have stated.
Okay. Because I was just looking at, you know, our annual margins have been in the range of like close to the range of like 26 to 28%. So I was just looking, you know, from why this 24%. So what is impacting us? If we are seeing a growth and there would be a better, you know, utilization of capacities, then why the margins would, you know, fall down to 24%?
Yeah, so you see the lot of, you know, contracts, a lot of orders that we've had are, you know, booked in at a time when, you know, the steel prices were at a different level. And there were some orders where, you know, we had to take that, you know, change in the pricing had to be, the pricing of the raw material did have an impact. So, but then the latest orders are all, you know, as per the current, you know, scenario and at a high rate. So that should offset. This is what we are expecting in the, you know, in the year. It should not go below this. That's how
maybe we need to phrase it like this. Okay. So basically the recent orders, what you have bid would be higher than the 26% margin as what you are seeing?
So overall in the year, it should be anywhere between 24% to 26% is okay. What we are seeing.
Fair enough. Yeah. Thank you. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you. We'll move on to the next question. That is on the line of Varun Seth, an investor. Please go ahead.
Thank you for the opportunity and congratulations on the good set of numbers, sir. So basically, my question is on the Kheda, which I understand that you soon will be starting in this quarter itself. And based on previous interactions, what I understand that you are supposed to start once the COVID situation settles down, once monsoon settles down, so maybe post October, and now we are hurrying a bit to quarter two. So are we seeing more robust demand, or the demand scenario has changed, or why we are you know preponing the capex, if you can throw some light on that?
So I think, you know, we are now, I think the situation is more clear to us. You know, the impact of COVID, I think, you know, the second wave has taught us a lot, you know, as people, as society, as you know, people in the industry. We have been vigorously, you know, pursuing, you know, vaccination of our you know, the workforce that we have here, both white collar and blue collar. We have made some very good progress there. So that's about it. And we are targeting to, you know, I mean, we always mentioned that, you know, we are going to begin the construction sometime in the month of October, but we see an opportunity to prepone it to the previous month. And we've already taken a head start on that. So we are in the process of renewing our contracts and, you know, we plan to begin the construction at this time without wasting any more, you know, further days in Kheda.
Sure, sir. So considering the preponement and considering the robust demand outlook and the order book, which we are booking. How do we now see our 1,000 crore revenue target, you know, which of course was delayed because of COVID. So now when do we expect to reach at that run rate level?
So like I said, you know, we have been talking about the key drivers for this, you know, towards this target are going to be, you know, the CapEx that we are doing, the market expansion that we are doing, the technological collaborations that we are doing. And Kheda is one of the biggest, you can say, building blocks for achieving this number. And that's also, you know, one of the reasons why we would like to accelerate Kheda, especially the, you know, the first phase we want to really accelerate and get closer to our target as early as possible. We are still expecting that, you know, in about FY 2025 is the target that we have taken for achieving our 1,000 crore number.
Okay, okay. And sir, question is on the clean room, so which I understand is basically will entail you to have higher value kind of orders, which will have a higher margin at the end of the day. Getting started somewhere in September. So in H2, how does it impact in our overall revenue stream because of clean room in terms of revenue and in terms of overall margins and, you know, going forward, if you can throw some light on that, sir.
So in the initial, you know, H2, we are likely to, you know, commission this by the end of H1. And H2, you will not see any impact there. But yes, the following half, that is the first half of next financial year, there will be an impact. Because we will be booking the orders at that time. And in the second half, maybe we will be utilizing the clean room as any other bay to begin with. So we're not going to wait for the, you know, the exotic metal orders, but those orders will materialize in the second half of this financial year.
Okay, noted, sir. So good luck.
So they will be executed in the first half of next year.
Got it. Thank you so much and best wishes for the future.
Thank you.
The next question is from the line of Aman Vij from Astute Investment Management. Please go ahead.
Good evening, sir. My first question is on the client addition side. Could you talk about what is our client number, total number of clients as of, say, June quarter, and how many new clients do we add every year?
It's a number of customers.
Number of new customers?
Yeah.
Yes.
Is that your question, please? Can you please repeat, Aman?
Yeah. My question is this only. Number of customers we have as of today and how many do we added in the last 1 year?
So new customer addition has, been muted in the last 12 to 16 months only because of COVID. However, you know, if I were to, you know, list those numbers, maybe, you know, the new customers that have been added to our, you know, our client list would be close to about 20-25.
And what is our base of customers as of, say, today?
What is that?
Total number of customers we have as of today.
Number of customers is... maybe it would run close to about 70-75.
Sure, sir. My second question is post the Udhav capex, what will be our capacity? So basically, what kind of sales can we achieve? And similarly, for the first phase of Kheda capex, when it will get over and what kind of peak sales can we achieve?
So, we have two units that in our plan to achieve the, you know, 1,000 crore target, revenue target. Out of which 500 to 600 crore is going to be contributed by Udhav. which is where we currently operate from, and which is the currently actually the only functional facilities that we have. So this contribution has come from Udhav, and the remaining is going to come from Kheda, and that is going to be divided into three phases. First phase, as I mentioned, is likely to begin in the by the end of this quarter, and it should take about 6 to 7 months to be commissioned. So that will add maybe about 100-150 crores of revenue to the top line in the following period. And similarly, it is going to be followed by a couple, you know, two more phases of construction in Kheda. The completion of Kheda, the three phases, is going to happen one phase each year. So the next phase is going to be planned in the next year, and followed by the, in the third year, the fourth phase, the third phase.
And so to utilize this facility phase-wise, so first phase, say, gets over in 6-7 months. So by what time do you expect one single phase key full capacity we can utilize? Is it, say, 1 year after commercialization, or is it, it will take time?
It should be. It should be anywhere between 6 to 12 months. Because we are already, you know, we are in the same, you know, the Kheda is going to be producing similar kind of equipment, what we had already, you know, registered with a lot of companies. However, in some of the, you know, public sector companies, the registration process for a new unit will take about 2 to 3 months, or in some cases maybe about 4 months or 5 months.
Sure, sir. And on the Udhav side, do we require any more clean rooms, or to reach that 500-600 crore target?
No, I think Udhav, this is going to be the final piece of CapEx that we will be doing here. That is going to cap the complete CapEx. The major CapEx is going to be capped here in Udhav with this clean room.
And when do you think we can utilize this facility fully?
Beginning next financial year.
So you are saying, say, FY23, we can see around 500 crore sales from Udhav capacity itself?
Yeah, so there is going to be obviously, you know, some lag in that because the clean room is going to be, you know, established. The product range is going to be established. The first few orders we will be executing. So, you know, it will achieve another 100 crores, or this addition 150 crores is going to happen over 2 years. So by FY 2023-24, it will be, you know, Udhav should be, you know, delivering about 500 plus crore of revenue.
Sure.
By FY24.
That helps, sir. The final question is on your export, the order book trend. So in the slide on page 17, you have given the trend, and we have been following this company for some time. So, sir, this number used to always be around 350 crore plus. And even last year, June quarter, which was much more, in terms of restriction, it was much more severe. The order book was much higher. So could you talk about that? And on export side specifically, so we used to have like almost 100 crore of order book from export. While this year, compared to March 21, it has increased, but it is still lower than what it was.
No particular reason as such. You know, maybe COVID is one of the reasons why, you know, a lot of projects we are seeing, they are seeing some delays, because, you know, major part of Europe, as you know, is still affected. So it could be, you know, that is the one reason. But one thing you must keep in perspective is that last year, on 1st April 2020, the order book was 267. And, you know, with that reference, if you can count, maybe, you know, we booked about 110 crores of, you know, orders. Whereas in this case, in the current financial year, we have booked close to 150 crores since 1st of April 2021.
Yes, sir. So when do we expect to cross that 400 crore barrier? Because
I think we have a good chance, real good chance of, achieving all-time high order book in this year, in the current year.
Okay, so in coming 2-3 quarters, you expect to have that barrier of. Okay, thanks for the clarification. That is from me.
Thank you. Participants, in order to ensure that the management is able to address questions from all participants in this conference, we request you to limit your questions to 2 per participant only. Next question is from the line of Shivan MS from GHP Securities. Please go ahead.
Good evening, sir. A couple of questions from my end. One is on the product mix change that we've been speaking about. So if you could give a more detailed understanding on how our product mix is changing and is going to be changing over the next couple of years and forward in terms of the capabilities that we are building in-house, any technological collaboration that would be needed, and how that would affect our industry standing and in terms of getting better orders and making our order book more holistic than what it is currently. If you could give some color on that, and how our margins would change due to that.
Per se, in order facility, we will continue to have similar kind of product mix between heat exchangers and other pressure vessels. But considering that our Kedah facility is going to be a heavy, we will be able to produce vessels, heavy vessels, as well as long towers and reactors. So per se, with Kedah coming in on board, we will have this more balanced. Since Odav is a facility, small compact facility, it is more logical right now for us to produce more heat exchangers, and that's how we are chasing our order book. But going forward, we would be seeing with Kedah coming up, we'll be seeing this more balanced. As far as technological upgradation is concerned, we have already 2 technical collaborations, and we are continuing to pursue it further to build up the more niche in our market offering. And your last question, so margins per se, it is not only dependent on the product mix, but yes, we are seeing, as of now, we are seeing that in most of the product mix, we keep the benchmark hurdle rate within us at the same levels. But it also depends on the law of complexity or the engineering expertise, which can be different across the product segment. So it is more dependent on the complexity in each product rather than per se product. On an average, we are looking at the margins between 24 to 26% going forward.
Correct. So sir, just taking this forward, I was looking at more from an application perspective. So currently, if you could give some color on what is the current application. So just pardon me if my understanding is a little less currently. I'm just new to the company. So if you could just give some idea out here, what are the current applications where our products are being used, and how is that application going to broaden over the next few years? Is there a particular chance of that happening?
So the product mix which we are catering goes across the industry segment. But yes, currently with we being more into heat exchangers, yes, our product mix right now is into more of refining. But if you see, if we get along our clean room from next quarter onwards, we will be more going into the chemical and pharma sector also, which consumes this exotic metallurgy. And also we are looking at the product mix coming in from paper and pulp business, which is also one this big segment which we are already present into, which will expand going forward. Also, then there are newer segments which will come up, like coal gasification and everything which we are pursuing. Although it is not still figuring out in our top industry mix. But yes, this our equipment cut across all the several industries.
So going forward, I think just to add to what Bhavesh just mentioned, chemical sector is one of the sectors where we will be making inroads. There is also going to be, natural gas and gas plants, where we already had a significant presence, and we need to, you know, perhaps take that forward in the coming quarters and months and years. Apart from that, fertilizers is going to figure prominently.
Okay. Got it, sir. And sir, my second question is on the revenue ramp up that we are targeting. So this is if you can just give some color that this is fresh demand which is going to be generated within the industry in the various sectors that we are catering to, or this would be more of a market share gain from some other competitor. If you could give some color here.
It's going to be a mix of both, you know, because we are gaining ground, and obviously, you know, to that extent, we are doing a lot of things that were being done earlier by our competitors, some of our competitors. So we are gaining ground as far as that is concerned, but also the opportunity size itself is increasing. So it's a mix of both.
Okay, but it would be more towards the capex cycle coming and setting in into the country. That would be a good understanding.
Maybe, you know, I would put it like this: that, you know, we have been able to you know, find newer areas where we can do a lot more for our customers, and we are giving them now options, you know, as a manufacturing option, which is much more viable than some of our other competitors. So I think that gains precedence over this other reason that you mentioned.
Okay, sir. Thank you very much, and best of luck for the coming quarters.
Thank you.
We'll move on to the next question. That is from the line of Ankit Babel from Shubkam Ventures. Please go ahead.
Yeah, good evening, sir. A couple of questions. Sir, you did mention that by FY24, the revenue contribution from your Udyog facility could be, you know, around 550 crores. So by then, what kind of contribution we can expect from the Kheda facility?
So, I would think, you know, anywhere between 200 to 300 crore, because by that time, two phases of Kheda would have definitely been commissioned.
So it's fair to assume that in FY24, if all, you know, barring any unforeseen circumstance, the company can do a revenue of around 700 to 800 crore is what the target is.
Revenue of 700 to 800?
Crore.
Yes.
Okay.
Focus of, you know, that's the whole reason why, you know, Kheda is going to come up.
Okay. And sir, so this phase one of Kheda, which you would be, you know, starting construction in September, October, so what kind of capex you are planning to incur in the first phase?
Yeah, so we are estimating a capex of close to around 75 crores, which would also include the development of the facility. So the capex after the first capex would to that extent would be slightly lesser. So this even will include the site development cost.
Okay, so then it means then that the capex for phase 2 and phase 3 would be relatively lower.
Yes, that is what we should expect. Yes.
What it could be, sir? How much lower?
Because it's going to cover more number of bays.
Okay.
Phase 2 and phase 3 are going to have more number of bays.
Yeah,
in that way it may even out.
Yeah.
But the revenue potential of each phase would be around 150 crores, right?
First phase? Yes.
The revenue potential of each phase would be around 150 crores, right?
Yes, definitely, as a minimum. The plant is going to be designed to be, scaling up further beyond FY25.
Okay, and so my last question then is that, the Kheda plant, what I understand is that it will be technologically better than the existing Udyog plant. And if I'm correct, in the past you have mentioned that the ticket size of orders would also increase once the Kheda capacity is on stream. So is it true, sir? Will the ticket size also improve? And do you see such orders, you bidding in the next, say, 12 months?
Yes, so ticket size will definitely increase since we are going to build up. You know, it would have a higher capacity. It would have a bigger standard bay. So technological capability wise, I believe we would use the technology for both the plants. But yes. Kheda, obviously, we will have the most modern facility.
Kheda, you know, we are targeting Kheda to be the best fabrication facility, as far as, you know, India is concerned. So that's how the aim that we have taken, and it is definitely going to be equipped with the best of equipment, best of plant and machinery, best of, layouts. So to that extent, I think definitely Kheda is going to be a benchmark in itself.
Okay, and sir, any risk to all these estimates, barring any unforeseen circumstances? Any other risk you foresee?
Your voice is not very clear. Could you please repeat the question?
Sir, any risk which you foresee to achieve all these things? I mean, barring any unforeseen circumstances?
No risk as such. Yes, of course, I mean, the pandemic situation we are dealing in, we don't know how it's going to pan out in the coming waters. We are anticipating that with a high rate of vaccination, maybe things are going to improve, and it won't hit us like it did in the second wave. But barring that, I think we have a market size which is available. We have a large opportunity, available to us. We have a very good track record. We have very good word of mouth amongst our customers. Repeat customers are continuing to grow. We are adding at the same time newer customers. So I think barring any unforeseen circumstances, no risk as such which we are able to anticipate.
Okay. Thank you so much, sir. All the best.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. We'll move on to the next question. That is from the line of Deepen Seth from Crystal Investment Advisors, LLP. Please go ahead. Deepen, your line is in the talk mode. Please go ahead.
Yes. Can you hear me now? Thanks for the opportunity.
Yes, sir. Please go ahead.
Okay. So I have a question on the apparent change in margins that has happened in this quarter, and it's not related to just, this quarter. But as we move forward, how does it reflect on the strength and the franchise of the business? I would have expected that, when you run with a typically less than 1 year order book, then you can book commodities pretty much through forwards. And to that extent, you are reasonably insulated from changes in steel prices, because the minute the orders come in, you work out a quote and, you go on that basis. So the 200, 300 bips loss, I think it's more than that in gross margins, is a little worrying. I'm not sure whether it's because of product mix change or whether it indicates the fact that, we really have to willy-nilly go by what commodity prices impose on us. That's my first part, and I'll ask you my second question later.
Yeah, I think what happens is that in the current situation, the options to get the best, the kind of prices that we were getting earlier,
right,
has become very limited.
Hmm.
To that extent, the supply chain itself is constrained. And it's not really the, we are in the business of buying steel, which is a specialized steel. It's
right.
Not really falling the, it does have a, definitely a large impact of the steel prices is there in that, but it has always been a, challenge for us. So yes, we do book orders at the time when we, as soon as we receive the orders, and that's what we try to do. But a lot of times what happens is that especially in the last few months since the pandemic has hit us, is that there is an engineering cycle which has got prolonged, because once we receive the order, there is about 4 weeks of engineering which is involved, 4 to 6 weeks, and that has to be complemented by approvals from our customers and freezing of that engineering inputs. based on that, the orders can be finalized. That the, you know, orders, though they are tied up, but the, you know, all holds can be removed and the orders can be given a green signal. The vendors can be given a green signal to proceed with manufacturing. So what we have observed is since the time the pandemic has hit, and also combining it with the supply chain constraints that we have, where most of the, you know, steel mills and most of the tube mills, the forging shops have been going pretty full. You know, that window of getting the best slot with the best price has got limited. And that has seen maybe 2%.
Yeah, so I'll take that with, a long-term view that, okay, it's a little bit of part and parcel of being in the business. You're still an outstanding quality business for me. If this goes beyond, you know, the 200, 300 bips that we are seeing now, that's when I will question, how great the business is in the mind of its customer. Hence, do you not have that pricing power? But for now, it's a little bit of fluctuation. We should learn to live with it. That's how real life is. No worries. The second question is that given the exuberance around the chemical industry and particularly specialty chemicals and also in a number of bulk chemicals or not so specialty kind of product lines, there's a whole lot of fresh investments being announced by so many companies across the spectrum, whether it's fine chem, whether it's the fluorochemicals guys, even whether it's the fertilizer guys and so on. To that extent, it's a little disappointing that your orders are still just, concentrated more than two-thirds in refining and oil and gas. We've got a great presence there. But frankly, outside of refining and oil and gas, I would expect a lot more flowering. I completely grant you the fact that, 300 crores or whatever we are today, and if I take another 50 crores in July, so maybe we are at 350 odd, is not a bad number at all. But I would have loved to see the composition tilting more and more towards chemicals.
Absolutely agree with you. I mean, that's something which has been, something which has been driving us as well to, venture out into newer sectors. And yes, chemical sector does present a great opportunity to us. And we are gearing up to capture that opportunity. This clean room is going to be one of the factors there.
Involvement?
We would like to do the pots and pans again in any of the sectors that we enter into. We would like to do the more specialized, the highest end equipment there. So that's where we are. That's where our forte lies.
Any traction in the API space, for example, or is that out of bounds for people like you?
There would be, because ultimately it is the process, it's a part of the process, industry overall. So it is going to be having opportunity for us. But like I said, we will be gunning for the most severe applications, most strenuous applications, which demand the best of material.
Are you doing anything high-tech like glass-lined vessels or something? Not yet.
No, glass-lined vessels is not in our product range.
Okay.
And the market size is really limited there.
Thank you, sir. Thanks for the clarity.
Yes, to take care of the market.
Okay. If I may ask one more question, sir. Yeah?
Go ahead.
Right. So just a little bit of housekeeping. I guess the group exposures are now out of the balance sheet completely.
Yes.
That is very hard. Thank you, sir. That will be all.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, that was the last question. I now hand the conference over to Mr. Rishi Roop Kapoor for his closing comments.
Well, thank you everyone for participating in the con call.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the Anup Engineering Limited, that concludes this conference. We thank you for joining us, and you may now disconnect your lines. Thank you.